Welcome to Fair Trade Finder. Today we're comparing two portable power stations, the EcoFlow Delta II Max and the Jackery 2000 Plus. We're going to look at battery type, storage capacity, power output, recharge time, outlets and ports, weight, internet and Wi-Fi, and any bonus details about these power stations that it's good to know. Let's start with looking at battery type, the type of lithium battery cells that these power stations use. Both of them use LFP batteries, lithium iron phosphate. This technology is more stable, less likely to overcharge, but most importantly, LFP batteries last significantly longer than other types of lithium ion batteries. Let's move on to storage capacity. The Jackery and EcoFlow have similar starting capacity. Jackery 2000 Plus has 2,043 watt hours of capacity, and the EcoFlow Delta II Max has 2,040 watt hours of capacity. Where they differ is that Jackery has the bigger expansion option. Both of these power stations allow you to expand on their original starting capacity. This means that you can buy additional expansion packs that you add to the power station and increase the amount of energy that it can retain. This is a great feature because in the past, you were stuck with the capacity that you purchased. You could never grow beyond that. You'd have to just buy an entirely new power station. The Jackery 2000 Plus has a maximum expansion capacity of 24,000 watt hours. You would need to buy two of these power stations and 10 expansion battery packs. You can connect the power stations together and have a total capacity of 24,000 watt hours. That's enough energy to run an entire household, depending on how big the house is. You can connect devices and appliances to that type of setup. If you only wanted to expand a single power station, you could expand it up to 12,000 watt hours. In comparison, the EcoFlow Delta II Max is expandable up to 6,144 watt hours. Next, looking at output. Output determines the types of devices and appliances that the power station can support. The higher your output, the more your power station is able to run energy-intensive devices like refrigerators and power tools and just larger electronics. The Jackery 2000 Plus has the higher output power. It has 3,000 watts with a 5,000 watt surge. The 5,000 watt surge is additional power that you can use on a temporary basis. The EcoFlow Delta II Max gives you 2,400 watts of output and 4,800 watts. So moving on to charge cycles, this is a very important feature because this gives you an idea of how long your lithium battery is going to last. A charge cycle is a full charge and discharge. That's charging the battery up to at least 80% of its capacity and then discharging it down to almost 0%. The Jackery 2000 Plus has the longest cycle life in that it gives you 4,000 charge cycles, while the EcoFlow Delta II Max gives you 3,000 charge cycles. You want as many charge cycles as possible. You're looking at about 10 years, potentially more, of use out of this power station, even if you were using it every day. These are both very long-lasting power stations, but Jackery 2000 Plus will last for longer than the EcoFlow Delta II Max. Next, looking at outlets and ports, this lets you know what types of devices you can plug in. What can it support? Well, the EcoFlow Delta II Max has the widest variety of outlets and ports. You get 15 total, while the Jackery 2000 Plus, you get 10. Just to go over what you get on the EcoFlow Delta II Max, 15 outlets and ports, you get 6 AC outlets. Those are the most typical types of outlets, like the outlets you see on your wall in your house. You get 2 USB-A with 12 watts of output per port. You get 2 USB-A fast charge with 18 watts of output per port. You get 2 USB-C with 100 watts per ports. You get 2 DC ports, 38 watts maximum output. And you get 1 12-volt car port with 126 watts. That's the cigarette lighter port in your car. Let's go over the Jackery. So the Jackery 2000 Plus, you get 10. Jackery tends to give you the least amount of outlets and ports, and EcoFlow tends to give you the most So the Jackery, you get 5 less ports, but you get 4 AC, and you get your standard 20 amps AC outlets. You also get 125 amp AC, which is more powerful, and you can plug in like bigger devices. This is great for people with RVs. You also get 2 USB-A 18 watt ports, 2 USB-C 100 watt output, and 1 12 volt carport. Let's look at charging time. You can recharge these power stations in a number of ways. The easiest one is by simply plugging the power station into your AC wall outlet. The EcoFlow Delta II Max has the fastest AC recharge time. It recharges in about 1.2 hours, so a little over an hour to charge the Delta II Max. The Jackery 2000 Plus takes about 2 hours. That's pretty fast for power stations of this size. In the past, power stations this large could take hours and hours to charge, even using an AC wall out. Moving on, next way you can charge is by solar. It's difficult to estimate solar charge time. It's really based on your setup, how much sunlight you're getting, if you've set up your solar panels correctly, the quality of the solar panels, the conversion efficiency, how much sunlight the solar panels are actually converting into energy. I don't want to give you an estimate on timing because I think it's not that accurate, but I can let you know the amount of solar input power these power stations can accept. Jackery 2000 Plus accepts a higher solar input of 1200 watts maximum, while the EcoFlow Delta II Max accepts 1000 watts of solar input. Next, moving on to DC recharge, the 12-volt cigarette port on your car is a popular way to recharge your power station. If you're camping or just living off-grid, using your car to recharge can be a great convenience. This is always going to be the least efficient way to charge a power station. The EcoFlow Delta II Max charges the fastest using the DC port. You can get it charged in about 21 hours. Whereas a Jackery 2000 Plus takes about 25 hours. So they're similar in that way. Weight. The EcoFlow Delta II Max is more lightweight. It's about 50 pounds, 23 kilograms, while the Jackery 2000 Plus is 61.5 pounds, or 27.9 kilograms. Moving on to one of my favorite features, app control, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi capabilities. Both of these power stations can connect to the internet and can also connect to smartphone or iPad via Bluetooth. The best thing about this feature is that you can remotely manage and control your power station through an app. Both these companies will have native apps that you can download. You can turn the power station on and off, monitor energy usage levels. You can get alerted if there's a problem. You can also receive firmware and software updates and security patches directly to the power station. It's a great feature. And once you use an app to control your power station, it's really hard to go back, especially if you're like camping. Bonus information about these power stations. One of the coolest features that they both have are different types of emergency power switchover. The Jackery 2000 Plus has an EPS switchover with a 20 millisecond switch. And the Delta II Max also has an emergency EPS switchover. This is not an uninterrupted power supply, so it's not a seamless transition. But if you have devices that you want to ensure don't lose power, medical devices like a server, you'd want to connect it to your EPS so that you never go without power. Moving on to recap. How do these power stations compare to each other? There's a few similarities in these power stations. They're both of very high quality. They both have similar capacity, great lithium iron phosphate batteries, Bluetooth Wi-Fi connectivity, all really important features. How they differ, starting with EcoFlow. EcoFlow gives you more outlets and ports. It also has the fastest overall recharge time. It's 11 pounds lighter. There's also a cool feature on the EcoFlow, as you can see in this bottom picture. In this newer model, they have a storage compartment on the top. You could put all your cables and gear in there, so it makes it easier to keep everything that you need in one place. Moving on to the Jackery has a higher output. It also has a longer cycle life, get 1,000 additional charge cycles. It also has these wheels and telescope handles. Even though it's heavier than the EcoFlow, the ability to wheel it around is pretty awesome, considering it is such a heavy power station. I hope this video has been useful. Please give this video a like and subscribe if it has been useful to you. Share your experience using Jackery or EcoFlow. These are both great products. Thanks again for watching, and I will be back soon with a new video.